Hey guys, welcome back. I'm sorry there's not been a live stream at the moment. I have been extremely busy with work, so I've decided to start a new game series. And yes, the red is back. I did it yesterday. I felt lost. I didn't feel like me, so I feel like me again. So today we're playing The Park. I don't know if it's a horror game. I don't know what it is. So let's go. I hope you enjoy it. Let's get right into it. Yes. I'm wearing headphones. It's not dark. Well, audio control settings and your sanity. I don't have any sanity. I'm insane. Don't tell anyone.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Where's Mr. Bear?
I haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum. Stay in the car. Go and ask information.
Oh, we're moving. We're going to find Mr. Bear. It is actually a really pretty game.
Attention, patrons. The park is now closed. Please make your way to the car park at your earliest convenience.
I'm in the car park. I need to get Mr. Bear. Where do we go? Oh, here we go.
Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath. Think about the last place you saw your son's teddy bear. Hey, stop! I think your boy just ran into the park. I'll unlock the gates for you.
Okay.
Callum, I told you to wait in the car.
Over here!
Over where? Get back here. Okay, I'm pretty sure that if that was my son...
There's something special about the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives. And on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention
employees, the park is now closed. Have a safe journey home. Oh, okay. And it's instantly dark. Okay.
Oh God. The park. What happened here?
What happened here indeed?
Callum!
Come back here. A flipping can. Watch me. Pretty sure I'd be running up. There's no way that kid can run that far. Oh. Oh, hey. Oh, that's lovely. What is this? Can I go in there?
Too dark. I'm not going in there without a flashlight.
Oh, you big sissy. Oh. Okay. Back to running. We'll shout for him again.
Callum? Where'd you go?
Catch me, Mommy.
How can you be speaking that loud when we can't even see him? Where did he go? This is a really, really pretty game. Oh. It's a shoe.
I think this belongs to Callum.
Okay. Oh. Oh.
Chad the Chipmunk, huh? Just a drunk guy in a suit.
Chad the Chipmunk, worst in class. Chad can't even seem to pass. Chad gets angry, likes to fight. Chad is beaten every night. Chad will have a dead-end job. Chad will die a useless That's lovely! Why can't I move?
I'm out, sweetie!
What happened?
Come on, this way.
Well, there we go. Oh, what's this?
What is this about?
Cannot see what that says, guys. That looks like eyes. That looks like eyes. We will have Who laughed?
Callum, stay where you are!
Well, where is he?
Come on, Mommy!
Come on. What, on here? Let's go then. Is Callum going to be somewhere in here?
Come back, Callum.
Oh. Let's enjoy the ride.
Near a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter, his wife and his two children, a boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel.
Hansel and Gretel.
They were very poor and had very little to bite or suck.
Is it story time?
What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband. We will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them there. No, my wife, I cannot do that, said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began to weep. Do not fret, Gretel, Hansel said. He crept out of the hut and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets.
Okay.
The next morning, the woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day. Clever Hansel leaves a trail of white stones behind them as they pass into the woods. When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house.
Okay.
After receiving a thorough scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter.
Okay.
In the morning, their mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again. Hansel broke his bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed. Abandoned by their parents, and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days.
Okay. Are you all following?
The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly strange house. Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls.
They're eating the house? Oh.
Nibble, nibble, little mouse. Cruelly at my house.
Uh-oh.
An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes.
That's a witch.
Oh, you dear children, who brought you here? Just come in and stay with me.
Nope.
No harm will come to you. But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother. Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you. The old woman offered them 2 enormous lollipops. Children took them and began to eat.
Nope.
You see, nothing to fear here. Come inside.
Nope.
The old woman urged, and the children, sweets, followed. Once inside the house,
what was that?
The old woman changed. She stuffed Hansel into a cage. And put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut. Your brother will make a good mouthful, the old witch told
Gretel. See, she's gonna eat them.
Once he is fattened up, I shall feast upon him.
Yep. She's gonna eat them.
Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven.
Oh, yeah.
But Gretel pretended not to understand. I do not know how. Where is the opening? Fool, the old witch said. The opening is here. And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old crone tumbled forward into the oven. Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel, and together they lit a fire beneath the oven. And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until the screams had stilled.
Oh, wow. Kids are safe then.
And then, because even children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.
Well then, I don't know how that's going to help me find Callum, but moving on. and let me get off of this swan that can turn its neck and stare at me. Well, that was an interesting story, wasn't it? Like I say, don't know how that's going to help me find Callum. But it was story time. On a creepy swan. Moving on.
Hansel and Gretel. I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest. The birds. The old witch. Even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister. Hand in hand against the unkind world. We were always hungry. Looking for our own house made of candy. Looking for the sweetness that could take the pain away. Hunger leads people to desperate, terrible places where the tree branches reach like claws.
Okay. Not really following this. Oh.
Another accident. This place.
Wasn't me. Can't see that note, guys. It's very annoying. And yes, that made me jump. I didn't touch it though. Oh! You know what, guys, I'm gonna end this episode here. I know we haven't figured much out, but that's, and we got a Hansel and Gretel story and a swan that tried to turn its head and I'm convinced was going to eat us, but that's not the point. But I'm gonna leave this episode here. There will be more of this. Unless you guys haven't enjoyed it, then I won't make any more. But if you guys liked it, let me know and I'll release more of it. So if you like this video, give it a like. If you haven't subbed already, please sub, become a destroyer today. Weirdness welcome, as my banner says, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!